my class. Today we are going to study about work and energy. We all know that nothing in this world can run or work without energy. Similarly, like vehicles, they run with the help of fuels. Televisions, refrigerators, washing machines, they run with the help of electrical energy. All living things, they get their energy from food. Plants get their energy from sunlight. So we can say that energy is the basis for everything. The amount of work we do depends on the amount of energy we have. So in this class, we are going to learn about work, the different forms of energy, and also the different sources of energy. The sources of energy include sun. The sun is the basic or the ultimate source of energy on the earth. And we will also learn about the energy we get from flowing water. The energy of the flowing water can be used to run electricity. So let's discuss in detail. Now look at what this boy is doing. The boy uses force to push the table. The table moves. So work is said to be done. The boy uses lot of more force to push the wall, but the wall does not move. So no work is said to be done. So you must understand that the force used on an object should cause its motion. Only then work is said to be done. So work is said to be done on the body when a force is applied on a body to make it move through a distance. For example, if a child pushes a chair and the chair moves, work is said to be done. Some objects do not change their place even when we apply force. For example, the almira does not move from its place even when pushed by a child. So, is work done in such a situation? No. In pushing the almira, no work is done because the position of the almira does not change.
We need energy to do anything such as lifting, pushing or pulling. Energy is defined as the ability to do work. Now we will first study the sources of energy. Sun. Sun is the main source of energy on earth. The energy that we get from the sun is called solar energy. These days, solar energy is used in solar cookers and solar heaters for cooking and heating. Plants use solar energy to make food in their green leaves. Second is wind. Energy from the wind is called wind energy. It is used to move the fan of a windmill to produce electricity. This helps to move the shaft of generator, which in turn produces electrical energy. Third source is water. The flowing water also has energy. It is called water energy or hydel energy. Energy of flowing falling water from dams is used to rotate the turbines of the generator to generate electricity. Electricity produced by the energy of flowing water is called hydroelectricity. Next source of energy is earth. The innermost part of the earth is very hot. The heat energy we get from this part is known as geothermal energy, which is also used to produce electricity. Next, fuels. We burn fuels such as wood, coal, petrol, etc. to get energy. This fuel like petrol and diesel are used to run our vehicles, and wood and coal are used for cooking or heating. Now let's study the different forms of energy. First, heat energy. It is obtained by burning fuels such as wood, coal, oil and gas. This energy is needed to cook food, for moving vehicles, etc. Second, electrical energy. It is obtained from generators, dynamos, chemical reactions in cells and batteries, etc. It is produced at thermal power stations by burning coal and in hydel power projects, which use the force of running water to turn a generator. Solar cell panels and atomic power plants have also been developed to produce electrical energy. Electrical energy is mainly used to produce light and run different machines. Almost every machine uses electrical energy in one way or the other. Next comes chemical energy. Batteries have chemical energy in them. This comes from the chemicals in them. When we use them, the energy is stored in them changes into electrical energy. Sound energy. Sound is also a kind of energy. When an object vibrates, it produces sound. And sound travels in the ear and reaches our ears so we can hear it. light energy. The energy that we get from light is called light energy. It is produced by bulb, CFL, candle, etc. We are able to see with the help of light energy. Even the plants use the light energy of the sun to make their food. Last comes the atomic energy. An atom is the smallest particle of the matter. Atomic energy is produced by breaking up or joining of the atoms. A great amount of energy is released when atoms break down or join. Atomic energy is also used to produce electricity in nuclear power plants.
So today we studied that work is done when force moves an object to a distance, and energy is the ability to do work. The more work we do, the more energy we need. Sun is the ultimate source of energy on the earth. Thank you.